Hello everyone, today we will go through the theory part of taxiway in your airport engineering. Now what is first of all the taxiway? It is a path for an aircraft at airport connecting runway with apron and hangars etc. Okay, that is when you have a runway and the flight has to move, the aircraft has to move to an apron, hangar or near the terminal building. So how it will move? It will move through this interconnecting path which are nothing but called as taxiways. Okay, the taxiways are marked with yellow color, the runways are marked with white color as shown in this diagram. About the marking, we'll read about it further. Now going to the taxiway, layout of taxiway. Now how do you decide the layout of taxiway? When you talk about layout, what else, what more comes is versus the arrangement. Aircraft which has just landed does not interfere with the aircraft taxiing to take off. Okay, so your taxiway arrangement should be such that the aircraft which has just landed should not interfere with the aircraft which is taxiing, moving to take off. Okay, then busy airport. Taxiways should be located at various points along the runway. It will then be possible for the landing aircraft to leave the runway as early as possible for making it clear for use by other aircraft. Such taxiway is known as exit taxiway. So in this paragraph, you know what is exit taxiway? When a flight, an aircraft takes an exit from the runway to another path, that path is called the exit taxiway. When an exit is taken from runway to the another path, that is called the exit taxiway. Now taxiways are should be located at various points along the runway so that the runway could be evacuated as early as possible. Okay, then crossing. Crossing or intersection of taxiway and active runway should be avoided. Of course, active runway, which is where landing or taking off is taking place. Okay, then route. The route of the taxiway should be made in such a way that it results in the shortest practical distance from the terminal area to the end of the runway used for the takeoff. Okay, so the taxiway should be such that it covers very less distance. The aircraft does not have to move a larger distance to the taxiway path. Then high turnoff speed. High turnoff speed means the maximum speed with which it can take a turn. That is, aircraft can take a turn. If exit taxiways are designed for high turnoff speeds, the runway occupancy of the landing aircraft is reduced and it will thus increase the airport capacity. Of course, that is, if the aircraft are moving with a higher speed to take a turn, runways will be evacuated as early as possible and that is why the capacity will be increased, that is more and more times the runway would be used. Okay, then geometric design standards. What are things you are supposed to keep in mind when you are talking about geometric design of the taxiway? First is the length of taxiway, second is the width of taxiway, then width of safety area, longitudinal gradient, transverse gradient, rate of change of longitudinal gradient, side distance and turning radius. Okay, we'll discuss about it one by one. Length of taxiway, as discussed earlier, it should be as short as practical. No specifications are recommended by any organization. Okay, so it has to be the distance should be small for the taxiway so that the aircraft does not have to travel long distance. Okay, then width of taxiway. Width of taxiway is lower than the runway width because when aircrafts run on taxiway, they are not airborne. Of course, when you are talking about runway, aircrafts are supposed to land from air to the land area or supposed to take off from land to air. Okay, so that is why slightly more distance is given, slightly more width of runway is taken as compared to taxiway. And obviously the speed of the aircraft is very much at runway than that of the taxiway. And therefore, for avoiding a few accidents, the width of the runway is taken at a higher level than that of the taxiway. The speed of an aircraft on a taxiway is also less than that of the runway. The advantage of this is the pilot can maneuver the aircraft over a smaller width of taxiway. So as discussed now, that is, the speed of the aircraft is kept lower on the taxiway because anyway the width of the taxiway is very less. So the pilot can move very easily and smaller speeds through that smaller width of the taxiway. Then width of the safety area. Now safety area includes taxiway pavement on either side that may be partially paved plus the area that is graded and drained. A width of 7.5 meter of shoulders adjacent to pavement edges should be paved with light strength material. Okay, so this is your runway, this is your taxiway, and these are the shoulders which act as a safety area. These are used in times of emergency for stopping. Okay, then since the aircraft does not use this safety area, or we can say the shoulders normally, so why these shoulders are needed to be paved? Because after the arrival of jet blast, the amount of jet exhaust emitted from the engine, especially during takeoff operation, is quite high, which causes soil erosion of material used in shoulders. Hence, the shoulder materials are needed to be paved. Okay, so it is because of the jet exhaust that should not erode the material, and that is why the shoulders are paved. Shoulders are paved with the following particulars. The shoulder must be thick enough to support the airport patrol vehicles and the sweeping equipment. Okay, so it should support those vehicles also. That is the strength of that vehicle also it should support, and also the sweeping equipment. Okay, so that is why it has to be paved. The shoulders should normally be treated with bitumen. The surfaces should be made of such material that does not disintegrate due to the hot blast of the jet engine. Okay, so it does not get affected due to the hot engine of the jet blast. So it has to be paved. It should be paved with such material. Then the surface should be smooth and impervious, of course. Then, see, this is how the jet blast looks from the aircraft. Then, longitudinal gradient. Longitudinal gradient means the slope along the length of the taxiway. Now, International Civil Aviation Organization recommends that the longitudinal gradient should not exceed 1.5% for A and B types of airports and 3% for C, D and E types of airports. Now, this classification A, B, C, D, E types of airports is previously discussed in previous lecture. That is, depending upon the runway length, the airports are classified as A, B, C, D and E types. Okay, so longitudinal gradient for taxiway should not exceed 1.5% for A and B types and 3% for C, D and E types. Now, this particular table which is there in your book also gives you the taxiway width for different types of airports and maximum longitudinal gradient, minimum transverse gradient and maximum rate of change of longitudinal gradient. And the safety area should be paved or unpaved depending upon the need. Okay. So, this is the table which you have to go through. Then, transverse gradient, that is slope across the length of the taxiway. Transverse means across the length of the taxiway. Okay. So, this is essential for quick drainage of water. Of course, quick removal of water. The water should not get locked on the taxiway. Then ICAO has recommended that the transverse gradient should not exceed 1.5% for A, B and C types of airports and 2% for D and E types of airport. Okay, so this is your transverse gradient, that is the transverse slope. Okay, see, this is your shoulders. These are your shoulders. Okay, then rate of change of longitudinal gradient. ICAO recommends that the rate of change of slope in longitudinal direction should not exceed 1% per 30 meter length of the vertical curve for A and B and C types and 1.2% for D and E types of airports. So, these are the values you are supposed to remember. Then, side distance. International Civil Aviation Organization has recommended that the surface of taxiway must be visible from 3 meter height for a distance of 300 meter for A, B and C types of airports and distance of 250 meter visible from 2.1 meter height for D and E types of airports. So, this is specified, so there has to be no obstruction. We are not talking about side distance. Okay. Then turning radius. Whenever there is a change in the direction of taxiway, a horizontal curve is provided, of course. It is necessary to design the curve in such a way that the aircraft can negotiate it without reducing the speed. Circular curve is most suitable for such cases, and radius of the horizontal curve is obtained by this particular formula, that is R is equal to V square upon 125 F, where V is the speed of the aircraft in kilometer per hour and F is the coefficient of friction, that is taken as usually 0.13. Okay. Now, for airports serving large subsonic planes, the minimum value of radius of curvature is taken as 120 meter irrespective of the speed.